Hey guys, so I'm starting the vlog out. I'm just sitting in the office right now. So I'm going to a show today, and I have warm-up today, and then tomorrow I'm showing in the meter jumpers with Miss Tyde, obviously. I'm getting picked up hopefully a little before 3 so I can get to the show at 4. And then I'm packing right now. I don't know what time it is. It's like probably 10 o'clock. And I'm just packing up, and I'm going to bring all my stuff to the show today. So yeah, let's continue to pack. I'm filming a video on how to prep your horse for a show though, so that won't be in this vlog at all. No, like, prep will be in the vlog. So my locker is over here, and I'm in this little tack room prepping all my stuff. So I have my clean saddle under here, and my 5-point breastplate, my breastplate, my girth, my warm-up saddle pad. I'm gonna wear burgundy today just for warm-up, my show half pad. And here I have my open front jumping boots, my crop, I have my stud kit or cork kit. And I tell everyone, hey. Okay, so my mom is letting me borrow her grooming box because mine is from when I first started riding, so it's all like this color purple, which is the worst. So yeah, I'm also using a couple of her brushes because I need to buy all new brushes because mine are all purple. So my collection has grown a bit. I now have a clean bit and bridle, and I have two buckets. I have a water bucket and a feed bucket. Okay, I honestly suck at vlogging because I've been up here for a couple hours now. I went home and I obviously changed into my riding outfit, and I've been like working on cleaning her up, but it's all in like another video. So I've been her bridle path, clipped her hooves, and I'm gonna go bathe her. Hey guys, so I'm all done cleaning her and bathing her. She's just drying off. I have about 10 minutes till the trailer comes to pick her up, so I'm gonna get her all like dressed up, and I have to put away my camera equipment, and then I think my mom's gonna come up soon and we're gonna pack up the car. Alright, so I have my package all ready. She is packaged up and ready to go. I think she likes this though. I think this is how she likes to be treated. Oh my gosh, this is twisting. But yes, she's good to go. Can you tell my color's navy blue? Like, alright, let's go wait for the trailer. Alright, we are waiting for the truck and trailer. Oh, my horse is pulling me. Come back, come back, come back, come back, come back. There we go. And I mean, can you tell my show color is navy blue? Like, the entire horse is navy blue, literally. Miss Tyde. So yes. Alright, so the amount of times I've said I'm the worst vlogger ever is many amount of times because I literally am the worst vlogger ever. But I'm here with Tyde. She's in her stall. We're kind of like unboxing right now the car. And I'm going to go ride now. My friend is here and we're going to ride together. So yeah, she's pretty happy. She's got her hay and her water. We're gonna go ride now. Hi!
She's a psycho from a Midwest suburb. No straight jacket could hold her. Wild eyes, they will lure me in her trap. I go mad just to hold her. Until I noticed that something was strange, out of my range. There was no way back, something went off in my brain. She was insane, here she goes again. A psycho from a Midwest suburb. I woke up and I told her, you warmed on me when the feeling's all gone. And I tell everyone, and the look on your face will slowly come undone. Cause it was all a front. And quietly, I say it to your face, that you will need to find another place to stay. And no, you won't know me when the feeling's all gone. And I tell everyone, hey. She's a loose cannon with a temper, so so absurd, hiding from the police, yeah. Took pills with the name I'd never heard, but they were for sleep, she fooled me. That's when I noticed that something was strange, out of my range. There was no way back, something went off in my brain. She was insane, here she goes again. A psycho from a Midwest suburb. I woke up and I told her, you warmed on me when the feeling's all gone. And I tell everyone, then the look on your face will slowly come on.
Hey guys, so my mom just filmed the courses for me, which I'm really happy about because I got them on film. It was amazing. I am no longer worried about memorizing my courses because I actually got to jump them, which you like never are able to do. But I guess this time they did put the courses up first, which was really helpful. We only jumped like 0.75 because I don't think you're allowed to move the jumps in the warm-up. But that's okay. I'm good with the height. It was mostly courses I was working on, but yeah, I'm really excited. I'm eating right now. Tyde's gonna, attractive. She's peeing right now. But I'm gonna untack her because she's probably hot. And I'm gonna take out her corks, and yeah, that's it. Well, I'll see you soon. Okay, now she's eating. I'm going to take off her studs because they are still on. And they, also, I forgot my grooming box, awkward, so she's just going like this apparently. Right, Mir? Alrighty. Yeah.
Loose cannon with the temper, so absurd, hiding from the police, yeah. Took pills with the name I'd never heard, but they were for sleep, she fooled.
Okay, I'm almost all ready to go. I'm taking that saddle pad with me and switching out because I'm not wearing burgundy tomorrow. We're all set to go. This is my little station. So yeah, I'm gonna go now. I think I'm gonna end like this part of the vlog now. I still have to go back and do chores at home, but yeah. Good morning guys, so it's show day and I have to be quiet because my family's still sleeping, but my hair is crazy right now, so I have to go do something about that. And what time is it? It's 6 o'clock, so that's not too early, which is good because I can, I don't know, it's nice to have her stay over the show. I've never done that before. So I'm wearing these pants, like these dry fit pants with my white breeches, bits belt, my area top, and then I'm gonna wear like a something over top of my shirt. But yeah, I'm going to finish getting ready and then I'll see you in the car. Hey guys, so we are driving to the show right now. It is 7:18 and we had to go do chores at our barn. So that's why we were like, yeah, that's why it took a little bit longer to leave. But we are on our way now and I'm excited. I have a long time to my class. Like, I'm pretty sure I'll be showing around 10 or 11, but I wanted to go watch some hunch arounds and stuff and the jumper rounds because there's a lot of jumpers today. Farewell. So Tyde is eating her breakfast right now. I'm just gonna go fill up her water. And I put Powerade here, I'll show you. I bought a Powerade for her for electrolytes. So I've been putting that in her feed and hopefully she'll drink it like a water bottle. My mom's here. And I'm gonna go fill up her water and go watch the 0.75 jumpers because we've already started. Yeah. Okay, Tyde is right there. Unfortunately, I actually forgot my phone. So, yes. The 0.75s are showing right now, still. And I don't know what time it is because I forgot my phone in the car and my mom left. So, I'm just chilling with Tyde and I'm gonna wait to do warm up until the 0.9s are going. So I'm with Paris. Man, I just missed you. She was in my video, our worst ride ever.
Oh yeah,
that was her. Which isn't a great.
It's all the internet knows about me.
Tyde is all tacked up, and I'm gonna go down now. I'm ready to go. I'm gonna go school.
Undone, cause it was all a front. And quietly, I'll say it to your face that you will need to find another place to stay. And no, you won't know me when the feeling's all gone. Tell everyone, hey. Just said something was strange, out of my range. There was no way back, something went off in my brain. She was insane, here she goes again. A psycho from a Midwest suburb. I woke up and I told her, you warned on me when the feeling's all gone. And I tell everyone, and the look on your face will slowly come undone. Cause it was all a front. And quietly, I say it to your face, that you will need to find another place to stay. And no, you won't know me when the feeling's all gone. And I tell everyone, hey. And I tell everyone. And I tell everyone. Drive me crazy, cause outside, outside is no feelings, baby. You say it's hard to tell what I've been thinking lately, but behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. You said we had it all, that shit would drive me crazy. Cause outside, outside is no feelings, baby. You say it's hard to tell what I've been thinking lately, but behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. But behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. Chicago's waiting for job offers on the table, and she tells all her friends that's why they think we're stable. But I got plans of my own, but better with no label. And I'm loving the way that you move to my vibe and you dance to my songs. But I feel like it's about to be me who goes off into something so wrong. No, I take it for granted. Knew I'd be breaking your heart, so I vanish. Soon as you walk out that door, I panic. See, I'm never gonna understand it. You said we had it all, that shit would drive me crazy. Cause outside, outside is no feelings, baby. You say it's hard to tell what I've been thinking lately, but behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. You said we had it all, that shit would drive me crazy. Cause outside, outside is no feelings, baby. You say it's hard to tell what I've been thinking lately, but behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. But behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love.
We were both really nervous going into it. The first jump, we went over it, and then the rest of that course was really bad. I had a really bad distance and I almost fell off, and then another refusal, and yeah, it was just, then we got, after we got another refusal, we got dismissed. So we only made it over 4 jumps and 2 refusals, which was not fun. I'm so not used to her refusing. She never refuses. So after she, like, that just kind of like knocked us so off track, because I was so like, oh my gosh, she just refused. Why did she do that? Next jump, the next course was the same thing, except for we only made it over 1 jump. We got 2 refusals right off the bat, which was super, like, I really went into this confidently, so I was really disappointed in that. But then I went down and I found the girl who had leased Tyde before me and has done a lot of the work on like finding leases for her and stuff, and she helped me a ton in the warm-up ring, which was really nice. So getting her distances, she refused a couple times over, like, there's like a couple like meter 10, maybe they were meter 20 warm-up jumps that a couple people just kept on putting up, so I just kept on jumping them. And she refused a couple times with the auxes, but we kind of figured out the root of the problem, which was that when she's not forward enough towards, like, she hasn't jumped, I do school a meter 10 at home, and I school auxers, it's just that when she's not forward enough off my leg, she gets kind of tired and lazy, which is really weird because I'm so used to her being such a forward horse. So we also think that she didn't get a very good sleep last night because she was alone in a big indoor arena and there was lots of birds, so we think she got a really bad sleep, which also added to like her just being super tired. So it was meter courses, and then they put the jumps up to meter 10, and then they switched the courses, and then we did meters and then meter 10s. So I obviously just did meters. So while the meter 10s were going, I was done in the warm-up with the Miranda. And then I went back up. My third round was a speed class. We didn't get any refusals, but we had one pull down, which was completely my fault. But also, I like forgot my course at one point, so I had to do a circle, which also counted as a refusal, even though like she didn't refuse. It just, like, since I did a circle, that counts as 4 faults. So I got 8 faults in that class. And the last class I did, which was a 2-part jumper, like, table lay jumper class, so there was this 2 parts. She got double clear, which was really exciting. She was definitely really tired. She'd been tacked up for 5 hours at that point, so she was super tired and had been like, I don't know, like she hung her legs a little bit more than she normally does, and she got, like, she touched some rails, but none of them fell off. She was very scopey and she jumped really well, so we got a double clear. We were at a nice hand gallop a lot of the time. And then I went clearing the jump off, obviously, so that was really great. And then I ended up with 4th place. Yeah, I was just really happy with how she did and how I did. And it was a really big recovery because the beginning was a nightmare. I didn't think I would be able to, like, do anything. I thought it was going to be horrible, but it ended up being really good. Sorry for talking for 3 minutes. I hope this doesn't... If you watched all the way, I'm really proud of you. Thank you guys for watching. Bye!